Good afternoon.
Oh, you can do better than that. Good afternoon. Great, great. I'm so glad to welcome you here and to welcome your sons and daughters here. Much earlier this morning, I was walking around with Unit 1 and Unit 2 and Unit 3, seeing people move in with those bright orange bins, standing lines, none of them terribly long. I want to thank you for trusting your sons and your daughters to us. I know what an extraordinary thing that is when you're a parent, because I sent my own children off to college now some 20 years ago, so a long time ago. And I'm living proof that you survived the experience. For how many of you is this the first child you've sent to college? Oh, quite a few. For how many of you is this the second child you've sent to college? Proof that you survived. For how many is it the third child that you've sent to college? Fourth? Fifth? More than five? Well, all of us that live in higher education, this time of year is the most exciting time of year because you're surrounded by so many beginnings. And these years, for traditional age students between 18 and 22, though we certainly have lots of older students too, it's just such an extraordinary time because they're trying to figure out who they are going to be as grown-ups. And it's going to mean for you, as I remember very well from my own experience, that the kind of relationship between closeness and distance is going to change for you and in your relationship with your child. It's part of everything you want for them, to see them happy, successful adults in the world. I thought I'd say a little bit about, this is a new beginning for me too. I started as chancellor on July 1st, although this is a campus on which I have many decades of experience and much history. But I just thought I'd say a little bit about the goals that I have as chancellor. The first of them is building community. I often have said that different colleges are like different kinds of communities. I was at Smith College as its president for 11 years. Smith College was like a small town. Everyone pretty much knew everybody else. There wasn't more than one degree of separation between one person and another. At Berkeley, there are more degrees of separation. It's like a city. And it really responds to city skills. So some of the most important things that you can do for your son and daughter are to encourage them to find their neighborhoods, to find their academic neighborhood, to find their extracurricular neighborhood, and to find their living neighborhood. This is a place where you have to knock on doors, that unlike smaller places, that this responds to, Berkeley responds to initiative. People are very eager to help, but they don't often come up to you and say, can I do this for you? So you can encourage your son and daughter to knock on doors, to ask questions, if they don't understand something or have a question, to ask it. There are no stupid questions. So it's really important to make the best of Berkeley to do that. But so one of my first goals, or my first goal, is building the sense of community on this campus that is so big, so urban, so diverse. A second goal is to enhance the quality of the undergraduate experience even more than it is now. A big piece of that is increasing our housing capacity. Berkeley doesn't have as much housing as we should have for our students. A third goal is diversity, enhancing diversity, and equally important, enhancing the empathy that is an important piece of diversity. A fifth is making the conditions as good as they can be for our faculty members' research. There is not a planet There is not a problem on the face of the planet or important to humankind that we don't have faculty working on it, and we want to get out of their way and make their research as productive as possible. This includes lots of opportunities for students, so your son and daughter should really insist, seek out experiences where they can work with faculty on research. And then finally, I'll be developing a new financial model for the campus. Berkeley is such an exciting place. When I came here now many decades ago, I fell in love with the campus. I fell in love first with the people who were your sons and daughters all that many decades ago, the students. They're extraordinary. They're quirky. They're diverse. Everyone has a different story about how he or she came to Berkeley. Then I fell in love with the faculty. There is not a subject on the face of the earth that a faculty member not only doesn't know about, but isn't extending our knowledge of. And then Berkeley is a place where history is happening. You get the sense of being in a place where just extraordinary things are happening. You're a part of that history when you're here. It's a kind of palpable excitement. I'm going to end with a story from my time at Smith. We used to have a gathering at the end of this day, move-in day, in which all of the new students, not 9,500 new students, but about 600 new students, came in our biggest auditorium on campus together with their parents and any other family members that were there. And each of the leaders of the administration gave a little speech. I gave a little speech. The provost gave a little speech. We always ended with a speech with the dean of the college, the dean of students. And she said, done an extraordinary amount to get your daughters, Smith is a women's college, so it was all daughters, to get your daughters to this moment. You've fed them, you've clothed them, you've nurtured them, you've loved them, you've helped them through all of the challenges and trials, the victories of their, you know, of their time up to this moment when you've arrived at Smith. And now, there is one more thing that you need to do in order to assure that your son or daughter has a successful beginning to her college experience. Go home. I know it's really hard because I've been there too, you know, all the parents in tears were coming back to my, you know, my memory and all those years in which I've lived through this day. But it will be an extraordinary experience. And if you don't hear from your son or your daughter, certainly my experience is it means that things are okay. So thank you very much for entrusting your sons and your daughters to us. I hope they have a fabulous first semester. My email is cchrist@berkeley.edu. I answer all my email, I read all my email. So if there are burning issues that you want to ask me about, I'd be happy to try to speak to them. So thank you very much.